Hello student, we are going to revise our topic reproduction in lower and higher plants, which we have seen in our previous lectures. So first of all, we will discuss about what is meant by reproduction. Reproduction is a process in which the young ones, which are similar to their parents, they are first of all synthesized by the process of reproduction. So we can define a reproduction as it is a process or it is the production of young ones which are similar to their parents or like their parents. So we also know that reproduction is of two different types. The first type of reproduction is known as asexual reproduction, and the second type of reproduction is known as a sexual reproduction. So by this method of reproduction, the different types of living organisms continue their races. That is, the continuation of that particular species is carried out by the process of reproduction. So first of all, we will see the process of asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is a mode of reproduction that does not involve the fusion of male and female gametes and produces individuals that are genetically identical progeny from single parent or the organisms. Or we can easily simply say that a process of reproduction which is carried out without formation and fusion of the gametes, that process is known as asexual reproduction, in which the gametes are not produced. Now this asexual reproduction is carried out in lower organisms by four different types of methods. We all know that the organisms are classified on the basis of their appearance in the environment as a primitive organisms and evolved organisms. Primitive organisms, in which asexual reproduction is carried out by four different types of methods. The first one is the fragmentation, the second one is the budding, the third one is the spore formation, and the fourth one is the binary fission. The spore formation is of two types. The first one is known as the zoospore formation and the conidiospore formation. This classification is based on the type of spores which are produced. We will see in the that specific point. The first type of asexual reproduction, which is known as the fragmentation, is generally carried out in the lower organisms like the spirogyra. So what do you mean by this fragmentation? Fragmentation is nothing but the individual organism is broken down into two or more pieces. That is, different types of fragments are formed. We can clearly see in this particular diagram, here the cellular structure of the spirogyra is present, which is broken down into two different types of the fragments. Each fragment then grows into the new individual plant. So this is the first method of asexual reproduction, which is carried out by means of fragmentation in the organism that is known as the spirogyra. The second method of asexual reproduction is known as the budding. It is carried out in some of the members like yeast, paramecium, etc. Generally, the process of budding is carried out in the unicellular organisms. So this is the cell of the yeast, which we can say as a mature yeast cell. At the time of formation of the budding, small outgrowths is start to develop on the same cell of that unicellular organisms. This particular outgrowth, which is developed on the parent cell, is known as the bud. This bud develops into the daughter cell. That process is known as the budding. So this is the second type of asexual reproduction, which is known as the budding. Now we will see the third type of asexual reproduction, which is known as the spore formation. This is the special kind of process of reproduction in which the sum of the plants produces asexual spores. Asexual spores, they are not involved in the process of sexual reproduction. On the basis of production of these asexual spores, there are two different types of spore formations are present. The one is known as the zoospores and the second one is known as the conidiospores. So what is the difference between the zoospores and the conidiospores? Zoospores are the spores which are produced in some of the organisms like the Chlamydomonas. In this type of organisms, the spores which are produced, they are motile. They can move themselves from one place to the another place. Therefore, they are called as the motile spores. So the zoospores are generally the motile spores. They can swim into the water and develops the separate individual plant. Therefore, they are called as the zoospores. The second type is known as the conidiospores. Generally, the example is the penicillium. Number of the fungi reproduces asexually by means of the production of the conidiospores. So what is the difference between the zoospores and the conidiospores? Zoospores are motile while the conidiospores are non-motile. They cannot move themselves from the one position to the another position. So they are the non-motile. These are the conidiospores which are produced onto the special kind of structure or the branches produced in the penicillium. These circular structures which are present at the tip of this diagram, they are the conidiospores which are non-motile, generally produced in the penicillium. The last type of asexual reproduction, which is carried out in some of the primitive members, that is known as the binary fission. Fission, that we can say this type of breakdown. Here, this process is taken place in some of the members like the amoeba, paramecium, etc. Here, the unicellular structure start to stretch, elongate from one specific point. And due to the elongation, the nucleus of that specific cell also start to elongate. And they are distinguished to form into the two different types of cells. The nucleus are also divided, the cells also divided, the cell content present in that cell also divides, and two daughter cells are produced. So in this way, by these four different types of methods, which are generally carried out in the primitive members, that is the first one is known as the fragmentation, the second one is known as the budding, the third one is known as the spore formation, which is of two different types. The first one is the zoospore and the second one is the conidiospores. And the last type of asexual reproduction, which is taken place in the primitive organism, that is known as the binary fission. By means of these four different types of methods, the primitive plants can be reproduced asexually. Now we will discuss about the another method of asexual reproduction, which is generally carried out in some advanced members, especially we can say as the different types of gymnosperms, angiosperms, which are called as some of the advanced members. That type of reproduction which is carried out in these plants is known as the vegetative reproduction. So what is mean by this vegetative reproduction? A type of reproduction which is carried out with the help of different types of vegetative parts. So what is mean by these vegetative parts? The parts of the plants which does not directly participate into the process of sexual reproduction, or the parts of the plants which generally participate in growth and development of the plant, those are called as the vegetative parts. These vegetative parts are root, stem and the leaves. So a type of reproduction which takes place with the help of vegetative parts is known as the vegetative reproduction. Now we have also seen that it is of two different types: natural methods of vegetative reproduction and artificial methods of vegetative reproduction. As far as the natural methods of vegetative reproduction, in our revised syllabus, the natural methods of vegetative reproduction are eliminated. Only artificial methods of vegetative reproduction are included in our revised syllabus. So you are not going to concentrate on the natural methods of vegetative reproduction for the process of theory much. For NEET exams or CET exams, you have to look over the natural methods of vegetative reproductions, which we have also seen in the 11th standard, that is the modifications which are taken place in different types of vegetative parts. These are generally useful for the process of vegetative reproductions, as those type of reproduction is naturally carried out in the plants. Therefore, that is known as the natural method of vegetative reproduction. So these natural methods which are naturally carried out in the environment, they are called as the natural methods of vegetative reproduction. Now artificial methods are those which are not taken place naturally, but are used to propagate desired varieties according to the human requirements. As far as the requirement of human beings, they are manipulated. Therefore, those methods are known as the artificial methods of vegetative reproduction. These various methods of artificial vegetative reproductions are as follows. The first one is known as the cutting, the second one is known as the grafting, and the third one is known as the tissue culture. So these are some of the artificial methods of vegetative reproduction carried out in the plants. Now we will see one by one the different types of methods of artificial vegetative reproduction, that is the cutting, grafting, and the tissue culture. First of all, we will discuss about the process of artificial method, that is known as the cutting. Cutting is the simplest method of artificial vegetative reproduction, in which part, we can say the vegetative part of the mother parent or the host parent is detached. It may be the stem, it may be the leaf, or it may be the root. Whatever may be the part which is convenient for the process of vegetative reproduction, that part is detached from the mother plant. Here in this diagram, we have seen that the part of the stem is cut from the mother parent. That is detached part is kept into the soil. At the time of process of cutting, generally the lower buds are kept inside the soil, while the upper buds are present above the soil, which we have seen in the previous lectures. So from that lower buds, the adventitious roots are developed, and from the upper buds, the vegetative shoot system is developed. So that is the simplest method of the vegetative reproduction, that is the cutting. The second one is known as the grafting. Grafting, a special kind of process in which two different types of the plants can be joined together with the help of this method. Therefore, it is known as the grafting. So at the time of process of grafting, the plant which is taken in a rooted condition is known as the stock, while the part of the plant which is kept onto the stock, that part is known as the scion. So this is the stalk, this is the scion. This part of the plant is taken as a rooted condition, and this plant is taken from another plant which possesses some of the desired character. It may be the high yielding varieties, it may be the good quality of the proteins, etc., etc. So they are planted. The different types of methods of graftings are there. They are the tongue grafting, or we can say the crown grafting, etc. So that is the grafting. One more type of grafting is also there, which is known as the bud grafting. Here, instead of whole stem, only the bud along with the surrounding bark is here. Here the axillary bud is present. That axillary bud along with this surrounding bark is separated from the desired plant. That part is kept onto the stalk, where the bark of that parent plant, which we call it as a stalk, is cut in a special kind of cuttings. The bark is removed and this bud is kept inside that bark like this. And after placing the bud inside the cut bark, the other portions which are we exposed, that are covered with the polythene strips, or we can say as a any kind of thick soap tape which avoid the aeration inside that pocket. After some period, these axillary buds which we have grafted onto the stalk, they start to sprout and develop into the new plant. So these are two different types of the grafting, either whole stem or the only bud is grafted onto the plant. The last and most advanced method of the asexual reproduction, which is carried out in the higher plants, which is also known as the vegetative reproduction, is known as the tissue culture. So what is meant by tissue culture? Here, instead of entire vegetative part, it may be root, it may be stem, it may be leaf, or it may be the bud, whatever may be the entire part. Instead of that, only the part of that part, we can say that it may be tissue, it may be cell, it may be the organ, they are used to propagate into the new plant. This method is also known as the micropropagation, because by means of which we can produce the small propagules, which is known as the micropropagules. So therefore, this is known as the micropropagation. Here, this is the carrot. From this carrot, a small tissue, we can say, or a single cell is detached from the mother plant. That part is known as the explant. This explant is generally grown on a special kind of structure, which is known as the growth medium. It may be in some cases, petri dishes may be used, in some cases, test tubes are used on the basis of, we can say, as the requirement of that experiment. So that tissue or the cell which we have kept onto the growth medium, that tissue or the cell absorb the nutrients present in this nutrient medium and start to divide and redivide. Due to that, a mass of cell is formed, which is known as the callus. Now this callus is again broken down or cut into the small pieces, and each piece is planted into the separate test tube, and from each piece we can produce the number of the, or we can produce a single plant. So in this way, here the part of the callus is kept in this nutrient medium. Number of growth promoters are there, which initiates the root system and the shoot system, which we have also seen that different types of growth hormones which are used for the initiation of the root system or the shoot system, that is the gibberellic acids and the cytokinins. So after that, organogenesis takes place, in which the development of organs takes place. Primarily, the adventitious roots are developed and then the shoot system is developed. Then the hardening of this, we can say as a plantlet, takes place in the test tube. And after hardening of the plantlet, that plantlet is removed and grows into the separate, we can say as a pot, and develop into the new plantlet. So in this way, these are the three different types of methods of vegetative reproduction, which is carried out in the higher plants. So all these plants we have discussed in our primitive lecture. So this is only revision. Now the second type of reproduction, which is generally carried out in all the different types of living organism, which is known as the sexual reproduction. So sexual reproduction is a type of reproduction which involves formation and the fusion of the gamete, male and female gametes, to produce embryo and then into the new plant. That process is known as the sexual reproduction. So here in sexual reproduction, two different types of gametes, that is male and female gametes, are formed. Therefore, it is known as formation. After formation of those gametes, these gametes are fused with each other. Therefore, it is known as the fusion of the gametes. And due to the fusion, the zygote is formed. From the zygote, the embryo is developed, and from embryo, the new plant is developed. As far as the angiospermic plants are concerned, for the process of sexual reproduction, special kind of structure is developed, which is known as the flower. This flower is absent in the remaining groups of the plants, algae, bryophyte, pteridophyte, gymnosperms. In these groups of the plants, the flowers does not produce. Only in angiosperms, the flowers are produced. The flower is a specialized reproductive structure of the plant in which sexual reproduction takes place. So the structure which is specially developed for the process of sexual reproduction is known as the flower. So the function of the flower is to produce haploid gametes and to ensure that fertilization will take place. So this is all about the sexual reproduction. Now in the next lecture, we will discuss about the process of sexual reproduction, which is taken place in the angiospermic plants by means of special kind of structure, that is the flower. So first of all, we have to discuss about the structure of the flower, then the different types of reproductive parts of the flowers, and the development of male and female gametophytes of the flower. So that portion we will discuss in the next.